You gotta turn all the way up.
Mine is.
Oh, you don't gotta start it.
I can't see my stuff.
There you go, right down here. You just hit it back. You should just go back to the previous song, usually.
I don't know what none of this here is.
Justin? Yes, you want to try to get to Justin?
Yeah.
There's pleasure. Okay. Pleasure.
Just what Justin, song? Play. It should be Justin, but it's not.
Let's make sure it's.
That's an original from Justin Mickles, Leland Mickles, and Latrice Mickles, now Brown, Latrice Brown, Family Affair. This is a tip from Teela. I'd like to thank you for allowing me to come to wherever you are on your computer. I just figured that out. I just realized you can't all hear me on the radio, but you can hear me on your computer. So welcome. You can also see me on your computer, so that's kind of spooky. But welcome, and thank you for allowing me to come into wherever you are checking us out for on live stream on your 690amtheone.com. So if you go to 690amtheone.com on your live stream, you can check us out. You can record us. You can download us. You can do all kinds of things with us. But be careful. We want to make it sure that it's all good. That's why we're here. It's all about all good. This is a tip from Teela. My name is Teela Mickles. I am the founder and the executive director of Compassion in Action. That's an organization that works with people who are confined in the state correctional system, all of them, men, women, and youth. We've been doing this, I have been doing this since 83, but Compassion in Action became official in 94, and we're working with people on the inside to help them understand what went wrong in their life to make decisions that they made toward the behavior that resulted in a criminal act. And now they're in prison trying to figure out what. And so we try to help them figure out what. And the only way you can do that is go to the core of the issues. See, once an individual has gotten into a drug addiction, and believe me, those drug addictions come real subtle because everybody thinks it happens to somebody else, never happens to them, but they come real subtle. And an addiction is just something that takes your freedom away. It takes away your ability to make a choice on your own. You can be addicted to a lot of things. You can be addicted to your job, where you just can't do anything with your family. You can't go to church. You can't pray. You can't be about God. You can't be about your neighbor. You can't be about your yard. Can't be about anything because you're addicted to your job and that paycheck, which is never enough, and you can't take it with you. You can be addicted to bad relationships. Some people get into a relationship, and they're so used to being beaten down, they're so used to being treated less than God's best, that if someone's not thumping on them, they're just cussing them out. They think that's a good relationship, when in fact it's not, because God made us all valuable. But if there's something that happened in your childhood early on, if your mother called you little MF every day of the week, and all of a sudden, you know, you don't feel like much than other than what she's been calling you, and then so you don't look for anything better than what you were told that you were. And so those are different ways that we help individuals discover, where did this start? You know, God didn't make pimps, prostitutes, gangbangers, drug addicts, shooters, killers, rapists, murderers. He only made babies. Everybody is a baby. And that's what's so wonderful about this time of the year. We are celebrating God Almighty, who created all the earth, who came into this world as a teeny weeny baby, totally dependent upon the environment around him. Just like these babies are born and they're totally dependent upon the environment around them. They can't get up and change their own diaper. They can't feed themselves. They can't burp themselves. They can't do anything. They're born into a life. They're born into an environment. They're born into people, a situation, which is either going to nurture them and take care of them and love them according to what they deserve to be loved and how they deserve to be cared for, or they're going to come into something else. And we all know what that means. So we just, with Compassion in Action, we just try to help people figure out, what is that? What is that thing that started your life wrong? And the best way that I do to help them look at that is, number one, try to remember your first very positive childhood memory. And you can do this too if you're listening. This is a good exercise for everybody. Try to remember your first positive childhood memory. And when you try to remember that, think, what were you doing? What was around you? What were your surroundings that made it so good, so positive? What were the things you were seeing? What were the things you were smelling? What were the things you were feeling and sensing? What were you touching? What was touching you? What made that moment so special? We ask our program participants to go into great detail for that first positive memory, because that sets a foundation for them to determine, with from that point, something went wrong. And then, where did you feel insecure? Where did you feel not safe? Where did you feel not loved? Where were you frightened? Where were you afraid, and what did you do with those feelings of fright, those feelings of being insecure, those feelings that you were not safe? What did you do with those feelings? Because when children experience things like that at a very early age, they're supposed to be an adult that's supposed to fix that. There's supposed to be someone that says, there, baby, it's okay, it's not you, it's okay, you're going to be all right. There's supposed to be someone that does that. But if there isn't anyone that does that, then that baby, 2, 3, 4, 5 years old, they try to do it for themselves. And that's just not the way God programmed us. We're not programmed to take care of ourselves at that young age. But for many people, it happens. A child might have got slapped and they don't even know why. Or worse things that have happened. And we know that there are worse things every day that happens. I just want to make you sensitive, parents out there. If you're a parent and you're 12 years old, because babies are having babies, I want you to be sensitive to the fact that there's a little bitty person, a teeny little life, that is totally dependent upon what you show them and how you treat them. That's going to depend upon their sense of value and sense of personal worth. Every baby comes into the world the same way, expecting to be loved, expecting to be nurtured, and expecting to be cared for. Why wouldn't they? They can't do it for themselves. So we try to help people go to the core, the very beginning, when things went wrong. Unfortunately, there are times when I talk with people and we are in our, people on our program, and we write to people on our program, and they're not able to come up with that first positive. As far back as they can remember, it was all negative and it was all bad. And in those particular situations, what we try to do is help them see what it could have been, or even consider what it should have been. What it should have been. Help them to understand God did not make them for that negative environment, but he doesn't interfere with our ability to make choices. So that means he doesn't interfere with other people's ability to make choices too. So if we were born in that environment and that kind of thing is what happened to us, then we need to help people understand there is a way out and there is hope and there is something better that can happen for them if they would just consider that. So that's where compassion in action is. We help people go to the core. Once they go to the core and they find out they have been wounded, they have been hurt, they have been violated, then they want to know how can they be healed. Well, there's only one way that a person can be healed of anything. Only one person that can fix what's broken, even though he's not the one that breaks it. And that's the one who created us. Because he created us with a plan. He created us with a purpose. And he knows all the stuff that we got going on the inside, the good, the bad, and the ugly. And he knows what to do with it. But being a gentleman, unlike the devil who takes away your freedom to choose with a drug addiction, he has to be invited. He wants you to choose him because you freely are inviting him. You freely want him to come in and show you something. That's the difference. And that's where you want to understand yourself on a level that nobody knows on the planet except for God. Well, I see I have my partner arrived in the studio today, and while I get a chance to talk with him, remember, tell your people we're on live stream, 1690amtheone.com. Check us out. And in the meantime, what I'm going to do is try to find some music for you while we get some Christmas music lined up. And see how you enjoy it. I got it. Amen. I'm Lost Without You by BB and CC Winans. What a beautiful, beautiful thought. We actually are lost without him. He's the one that can fix anything that's broken. He's the only one that can. And he does it out of love. He doesn't do it out of, you know, what can you do for me? And you should this and you should that. That's what religion is telling people. Religion keeps telling people that you have to be a certain way. But God says, no, just let me love you. So you are listening to A Tip from Teela on 1690 AM, The One Radio. You can get us on live stream. And if you get us on live stream, you get to see us and how we be looking. 1690amtheone.com is where you need to go. In the future, Lord willing, we'll be on FM and we can get some stuff out on the radio. But for now, live stream is the only place that you can get us. And we're celebrating this time of the year. We talked about it last week, that you can just calm yourself right about now and get into the true meaning of Christmas. Since I work with people who are in prison, I sent them all a letter. They all got my Christmas letter, letting them know that they were in good hands. They were in a good position because they were right where Jesus would go today. He'd go right there and check them out. He wouldn't be out here at the mall. He wouldn't be at the White House. He wouldn't be none of these places where people think it's so important to be. He would be where the people are hurting. He would be where the people are hungry. He would be where the people are misunderstood. He would be where the people are kicked to the curb. How do I know that? Look how he was born. Give me a break. Really? It bad enough that he was born in such a common state that he was born, but there was no room in the shanty. There was no room. We're not talking about, you know, the embassy suites. There was no room for him in the little town of Bethlehem. So he goes into the cave where the animals are. Animals stink. They just stink. So this is where Jesus Christ was born, where the animals stink. And this is how he came into the world, this little bitty innocent baby, which is why I try to let the individuals know that we work with who are in prison, who are coming out of prison, and who are transitioning back into the community, that they are important because God created us all the same, babies. babies who need love, babies who need to be nurtured, and then crap happens, or life happens, or crappy life happens. Whatever, the person begins to make changes, they begin to make choices, and if an individual can go back to see where it began, then they can start to disarm the demons that lock them up today. It's very good to be honest with yourself. Unfortunately, the truth hurts, and a lot of people fake it till they make it. That's what the men tell me in prison. They, oh, we just gonna fake it till we make it. And like, and what is it that you're going to make? Explain to me. Help me understand. If you're faking it until you make it, what is it? And the conversation stops. Because you really don't have anything solid. You don't have anything of value. You don't have anything of worth. You don't have anything that you can build on. You don't have anything that you can dream from. Because you faked it. So if a person can be real with themselves and just be honest with themselves, even though the truth truly hurts, that's where God can come in, because he can deal with the truth. He don't mess with no lies. The devil's all over the lies. But God can work with the truth. The truth does hurt. And you know what else about the truth? It's easy to remember. You can remember something that's true in very deep detail. But a lie, my goodness gracious, you bounce that lie all around. You add a little bit to it. You take a little bit from it. Then you talk about who said this and who said that. A lie is a mess. But the truth is easy to remember. So if we help our individuals understand the truth about themselves, and not in a condemning way, not in a judgment way, but in a discover the treasure way, because see, God made us all very valuable. We're all treasures. Unfortunately, some of us are hidden treasure. And so we ask the gentlemen and the women and the youth that we work with, are you willing to dig for the gold? Are you willing to dig for the treasure? Are you willing to go for the gold? Because it's going to take a lot of work. It's going to be hard. It's going to be difficult. And you're going to have to roll up your sleeves. You might get dirty. You might get a little snot on you, a little tears, some blood. Who knows? But you're the treasure that you're digging for. And you're worth all the work. You're worth the labor. You're worth the time, the blood, sweat, and the tears that it takes to dig for that gold. If you don't discover the gold that you are, then someone else will. And you better believe it. They're going to use you the way they think they should use you. They're going to use you any way they want. That's why we personally validate the people that we work with. And if you're just tuning in, I'm talking about Compassion in Action. We're located in the former Wesley House, 2001 North 35th Street. We've been there since 2013. Looking for the new year of some great things to happen. There is a church on our property which is just going to be vacated at the end of the year. It also goes with our property, and I'm not going to lease it out to any churches, so please don't call me for a lease. That's not going to happen. We're going to transform that into the Compassion and Action Music and Performing Arts Center, so the entire community can get some lively, active demonstration and performance of some real good stuff. I'm so excited about that, because I know major players in the community who are master musicians, artists, singers, performers, and they'll get an opportunity to do what they know best to do in that environment. So we hope that you will continue to pray for us. And if you want to give us some input about what you thought about our broadcast, please, you can call Compassion in Action 24/7. Now you're going to get a voicemail if you call 24/7, because we're only in the office from 9 to 5. But 24/7, you can call Compassion in Action. That number is 402-502-9890. You can let us know not only what you think about the program, but if you have some community events coming up, like neighborhood association meetings, you might have a church function that's coming up, you might have a community meeting that's coming up, we will be more than willing and very excited to broadcast those times and places and locations for anything positive that's going to benefit the community. Like I said before, I ain't going to be talking about, you know, party over here, party over there. I'm not going to broadcast or tell anybody about your party unless it's my party. So we're going to take a little smooth away from my talking and get into some Christmas music, since my son Leland is here. Leland Maestro Mickles. Maestro is his name. Most of you know him. He is amazing. He's been amazing all his life. He's been, you know, playing music and singing songs. Y'all don't know he can tap dance too. Now that you do, next time you see him, tell him to cut you a step. You're gonna hate me for this. He used to be in gymnastics also. Oh, my kids are very talented. Check this out. Don't go away. Give him the glory, give him the praise off of Leland Mickle's Christmas CD. If you'd like to get one, you can call 402-502-9890, which is Compassion in Action's number, and we will put you down on the order sheet and get it to you as quickly as possible. They are $12.50. So, or is it $15? $12.50. So, Compassion in Action, you can call and get yours. And that's just one of the cuts from it. That's 402-502-9890. And this is a tip from Teela. We are on live stream, 1690 AM, theone.com. Check us out and let us know what you think. We were talking about this time of year being a special time of year. And if you're poor, if you're lonely, if you're miserable and unhappy, then you can probably relate to the real actual Christmas, the way things started in the beginning. Not that people were miserable and happy, because once they got the news that the Son, Jesus Christ, the Savior of the world, was going to be born, people got happy. Most people don't know why they got happy. Just like this time of year all over the world, people don't know why they feel what they feel. But this is the only season that they feel this way. You don't feel this way after January 1st for 2 weeks. You don't feel this way in the middle of the summer for 2 weeks. You don't feel this way in the fall for 2 weeks. You only feel this way this time of the year for 2 weeks. Well, I take that back. It's really kind of like for a whole month. Everybody's anticipating this one day. Now, some people have called it something different, but it's still during this time. Some people don't even want to call it anything, but they're still experiencing something. If it's denial, if it's irritation, if it's depression, they're experiencing something for this time of the year, because something so significant took place in this world more than 2,000 years ago that it has affected the world then, and it continues with this ripple effect to affect the world now. Now, nobody's birth has affected the world like that except for Jesus Christ. So whether you believe him, whether you don't believe him, whether you're excited about him, whether you could care less, doesn't matter. Something happened so significant more than 2,000 years ago that it split history right in two: B.C., before Christ, A.D., after the day of our Lord. And the historians knew it at that time. And the further you get away from the date, the more you try to water it down and take it away and change it and transform it. But remember what I said earlier in the broadcast: the truth is easy to remember. And the truth does not go away. The truth stands solid all by itself, the truth. And that's why we try to work with our people, just to help them understand their personal worth, their personal validation. That's the truth. Now, I don't try to psych them out and try to, you know, pull a book out or get a report or get a case study or a theory and try to figure out, according to this man-made theory and this case study and this book learning project, you should be this and you should be that. I would never do that to a human being, because that's intellect that comes from man. But God creates masterpieces. He creates one of a kind, an original, not a cheap copy. And you're so valuable and you're so important to him, you want to find out who that person is. And you want to find out by the originator, the designer. If you spend a lot of money on some special design vehicle that costs you all kind of money because you made it be the way you wanted it to be and it came from the dealer or the manufacturer according to your specifications, you are not going to take that puppy to Jiffy Lube for an oil change. You want to take it right back to the originator because it's so unique. And I'm talking about a stinking car, okay? So how much more a human being, how much more a person that God took the time to create and put into you specifics that is not in any other individual, making you unique, making you an original design, making you worth digging for the gold that's inside of you so you can ask God to fix what has been broken. We live in a society today where people want to blame folk and we want to, you know, get marijuana legalized. You know, that'd be fine if marijuana was legalized. That means you legally can fry your brain. You legally can set a horrible, terrible example for young people. You legally can continue to give our children asthma so they grow up to be this fantastic athlete, but they're dying on the field because they got asthma because their mom and daddy was legally smoking weed all in the house while they were trying to grow up. Why do you want to legally fry your brain? Let me help you understand something. Anytime you have to put a chemical into your God-created body for you to get some type of results, you are messing up the original design. And what you're making the original design crave and desire the chemical. And so you become a prisoner to the chemical. You are no longer a free agent. You are no longer one that can think for yourself, act for yourself, rationale for yourself, have dreams of only God knows what kind of future for yourself, because you can't do nothing without the chemical influence. That means your freedom has been violated. Your ability, your free will, your gift of free will has been totally contaminated and violated. And that's what the enemy wants from you. Why? Because then you're under control of something else. You're under the control of a force outside your originally created body. That's not cool. That's a prisoner. You're in prison and don't know it. So I'm done on that part now, but I want you to think about that, because if you can't stop, then you are already addicted. And like I said at the beginning of the show, there are a lot of things that we're addicted to. And all that means is that it can be food. All that means is that you let some chemical, some food, some job, some relationship, some material thing have control over you outside your body. And it has compromised your freedom to choose. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there's liberty. God wants us to choose. That's why he created the situation in the garden, so Adam and Eve could choose. God wanted them to choose him, not be forced to love him and to serve him. He wants us to choose him, not be forced, not be feared, not be fighting. If you don't love God, if you don't serve God, you're going to go to hell. That's fear. God doesn't do that either. He wants us to understand how much he loves us and how much he wants us to choose him so he can demonstrate that love in our life. Don't go away. This is a tip from Teela, 1690 AM, and you can live stream us, 1690amtheone.com. You can check us out. Call us 402-502-9890. Let us know what you think and give us your request, and also give us your information so we can let the community know all about you. That was Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer off of Leland Mickle's Christmas CD. If you're interested in getting one for yourself and say that you have an original from the original, just call 402-502-9890 and put in your order. We'll make sure that you get one. It's not too late. And it'll be a nice keepsake, a good Christmas present. And also, we want to hear from you. Let us know how we're doing. Let us know if you have anything coming up that you want us to broadcast. I'm sure we're going to be here next week. And we're really looking forward to 2016. And I don't jump into stuff. You know, I like to trust the Lord and appreciate 1 minute at a time, 1 breath at a time, 1 heartbeat at a time, because that really is all that we get at a time. A lot of people say 1 day at a time. But you know what? Sometimes there are some people that woke up this morning and their day didn't get finished. So it's even more important than a day. And if we can understand how really valuable we are, you are as a person, then you will respect and understand how valuable another person is. And don't listen to everything that you hear. Get the facts for yourself. When you see the 6 o'clock news and you see all this pain and all this tragedy and all this violence going on, don't jump on that bandwagon. Oh, Omaha is a terrible place to be. Ask yourself some questions. Number one, now don't get mad at me, but this is my first question. Do you smoke weed? Because, see, that's an illegal substance. And there are several things that have to take place in order for that to happen. And there are some young people that have gotten into that business and they lost their lives behind it because they were trying to look and be like somebody else. There are some young women who have lost their lives because their boyfriend pimped them out so that they could be a part of that business. So that's the first thing that we might want to think about. Who is this really affecting? The second thing, are you a tutor? Do you help children with their homework? Do you connect? Are you connected to a public school someplace where you can find out from the teachers who are really overloaded? How can you be a volunteer to assist? Are you a mentor? See, we have a need for mentors. Everybody knows that mentors work. We have a lot of mentor organizations that are going on. One of the real successful ones is the one that the former Tom Osborne, he's got a major book out called Mentoring Matters, and he understands the power of mentoring. The Boys and Girls Club need mentors. The Big Brothers, Big Sisters, they have like 50 women waiting for a little sister to mentor, and they have about 200 boys waiting for a man to mentor them. So if you're not a mentor, if you're not tutoring, and if you're setting a bad example, then you're part of the problem. You're not a part of the solution. And there are different ways that you can get plugged in. We have some very wonderful, active neighborhood associations. We have some neighborhood outreach church groups. We have individuals that just posse through the neighborhood trying to see where they can be helpful in trying to disarm any type of violence. There's an organization called NOSE, N-O-S-A-N-N-O-S-E, something about neighborhoods or safety. I'm so sorry, Robert Wagner, I'm jacking it up for you. But this is a gentleman who took it upon himself to become a role model and to scope the neighborhood. They kind of like patrol the neighborhood. And most of his posse are women. He says he only has one man that shows up to assist him, and the rest are women. So there are other things that you can do in this community that really make a difference, and you can be visible to the very people who need our help the most. The police department does police department stuff. The Board of Education, Omaha Public School, they do Omaha Public School stuff. The church hopefully does more than just church stuff, does a little bit of outreach and some of that feeding, some of that clothing, and yes, we know that they do. All agencies, all individuals, they do their part. There are people feeding the homeless. There are people clothing individuals. There are people training and providing jobs. Find your lane. Find where you are. Find where you can be helpful and not just hurtful, run in your mouth and talk about something. Be helpful. You all have neighbors and you all have friends. And then, you know, you might even know some things that can help, you know, end some of this violence and get some of these people off the street. Don't feel bad about locking somebody up. The worst thing ain't being in prison. The worst thing is being dead without Jesus. The worst thing is not being in prison. We got some dynamite prison ministries, and we got some dynamite prison resources. Compassion and Action is one. And there are a lot of individuals that know, because they said it with their own mouth, that coming to prison saved their life. Because they would have continued on that same path of destruction, hurting themselves and hurting other people if that didn't happen. And let me tell you something else about our brothers and sisters who are confined. I have not met anyone said, I didn't do it. I met two people that said they didn't do it, and they really didn't. One of them died before he was proven innocent, and the other one died from a sickness, and both of them were innocent. Most of these individuals come to the realization that they have committed a crime and they have hurt people. And they're seeking forgiveness from these individuals, the victims and their victims' family, and they're seeking forgiveness for themselves. And that's not the majority, but it is the majority of individuals that I've worked with Compassion and Action, and that's quite a few. So it does kind of change a person's mindset. So don't feel bad if you're going to turn a brother in, get him off the streets, he can get some help, and stop, you know, hurting people, because hurt people truly do hurt people. This is A Tip from Teela. You are listening to us on the live stream, 1690 AM, theone.com. We want to hear from you. Please call 402-502-9890 and let us know how you feel about it. You can also order your Christmas CD by Maestro Leland Mickles, and you can also let us know what are some of your activities going on in the community. We will announce them and let the whole world know. So thank you for listening.
We're about to go on a sleigh ride. Y'all ready to go?
Going on a sleigh ride.
All right. Let's have some fun. Come on.
Jingle bells, yeah. Jingle bells, yeah. Jingle all the way.
Yeah.
On a sleigh ride.
Come on. Yeah.
Jingle bells, jingle bells.
Sleigh.
Over the fields we go, laughing all the way. Oh, bells on bobtails ring. Oh, making spirits bright. How fun it is to ride and sing on a sleigh song tonight. Snow in a one horse open sleigh. Over the fields we go, oh, laughing all the way. Oh, bells on bobtails ring. Oh, making spirits bright. Oh, how fun it is to ride and sing on a sleigh song tonight.
It's Jingle Bells, Jingle Bells, Jingle All the Way with none other than Leland Maestro Mickles, my amazing son. And that comes from his Christmas CD, which you can purchase if you like, $12.50. If you just call 402-502-9890, that's Compassion in Action. You can call that 24 hours a day and leave a message. We're not there except for during business hours, but you can leave a message. And we want to thank you for allowing us to come on your computer for through live stream, 1690amtheone.com. If you're looking at us for the first time, hey, thank you for checking us out. And if you like what you see, make sure you let your friends know about it, because we will be here every Wednesday, 5 to 6, right here on 1690 AM The One. I wanted to give you some information about Compassion in Action. We were the site for the city planning meeting for one year. It was a two-year project, but they came to us for the last year. And the city planning assistant, director assistant, Mr. Dave Thomas, was giving the last meeting that we had on this past Thursday, and I presented him with a piece of artwork from Tecumseh Prison. Chris Garza is the artist of this beautiful piece of work, and I presented it to Dave Thomas. Chris Garza is a young man who was sentenced to a life without any chance of parole when he was 17, but thanks to some amazing community leaders, including Brenda Consul and some others who went to Washington, D.C. and said, this is whack, this is unusual and cruel punishment. Why would a child be tried as an adult and then given a life sentence with no chance of parole when the child ain't even an adult in his head until he's about 25? And so, of course, it was overturned, and now all those individuals, there's 35 of them in the state of Nebraska, who get their sentence to reheard. And they're going to have their sentence hopefully reduced, where at least they get a chance for parole. And so Chris Garza is one of them. He's been working with our organization for about 3 years now. He's a cool dude, and we have several pieces of his artwork in our building. If you'd like to come by some time and check it out, we're at 2001 North 35th Street. We are located in the former Wesley House. I say former, that's no longer the Wesley House, that is now Compassion in Action. And we will be transforming the church that's on our property into the Compassion in Action Music and Performing Arts Center. That's going to take place sometime this summer as we get volunteers and funders and different people help us renovate that building. And then we're going to open it up and just praise God with the best singing, the best acting, the best art, the best music, the best rap artist in the country. They will be coming out of there. What you say? Yeah, that's what's going to happen. So I just wanted to let you know that God has used Compassion in Action for some very significant things. We are also the center for information. We get a lot of information from all the community agencies. So if you're a resident in that area, we have stuff from Charles Drew. We have information from Teddy Bear Hollow. We have information from the city planning department. We have information for mental health, for drug addictions, for housing, you name it. We have information for free services and free classes, financing, all that kind of stuff. If you want to know about it, just come on by Compassion in Action, 2001 North 35th Street. We are there 9 to 5, Monday through Friday. That also is the home of the only gang prevention program in the city. It's called the Raw Dogs Youth Corps Gang Prevention Program. The originator of that program is Dr. Joseph Jennings out of Atlanta, Georgia, who passed, went home to be with the Lord October 7th of 2013. However, he gave me the program before God took him home, and I am in contact with his wife, and we are taking his memory, taking his program, and expanding it to the next level. Currently, we have about 26 young men from ages 5 to 13. This is a gang prevention program. We have the police department, we have Omaha Public School, we have many community agencies that are doing gang intervention, where they're working with young people who are trying to get out of gangs and trying to keep them from being pressured to get into gangs. But this is gang prevention. Our boys have not been involved, so we don't have to worry about taking their gun away from them later when they're trying to defend themselves, because they ain't going to have none, because they're not going to no gang. And so if you want to know more about that, it's 402-502-9890. Compassion in Action, 402 502-9890. We want to thank you for allowing us to spend this time with you. We want to wish you a very Merry Christmas. This is a season about the birth of Jesus Christ, who came into this earth in the tiny womb of a little virgin woman, the most humble way he could come, totally dependent upon her and however she would treat him and however it would be for her. And so here we are, celebrating his birth and what he has done and who he is in our lives. And so that's what Christmas is all about. So don't get bent out of shape if, in fact, you feel like you're not with the swing of things, you don't have the money, you don't have the this, you don't have the that. You can then have the true meaning of Christmas. And so we're going to let you go for now. We'll be checking with you this time next week. And thank you for allowing us to be a part of what you're doing. Make sure you tell your friends to tune us in live stream 1690 AM, theone.com. Go in peace and God bless you to love and serve the Lord. This is Teela from A Tip from Teela, signing out.
It's all about you.
I'm living my life for you. I'm willing to die for you.
It's all about you.